NephilimFree here, with a question for every evolutionist in the world, whoever they may be. Something for you to consider and ask yourself. You know, evolutionists have this Darwinian tree of life, they call it, whereby they believe that organisms can be organized by taxonomy and genetic similarities, and this demonstrates evolution, the relatedness between the phylum, genus, families of life. And they believe that evolution has produced all these various kinds of life. And they believe in abiogenesis. Well, you know, abiogenesis has been discredited. Evolution has been discredited. And that's why evolutionists are now starting to espouse this absurd panspermia idea, that life somehow came to the Earth on a rock, which is absurdly completely absurd, and still doesn't negate the intelligent designer. However, imagine this. Here's something for you to ask yourself if you're an evolutionist. You believe in evolution, right? You believe that the Darwinian tree of life somehow supports your ideas. And you believe that, now, if we follow evolution backwards, we get to abiogenesis. Now, evolutionists have worked hard to try to separate themselves from, to distance themselves from abiogenesis, because it's been demonstrated to be so absurdly crazy, the idea, according to what science, what we observe in science about life and about chemistry. So abiogenesis has been proven to be really nutty, the idea that life could arise, the first cell could evolve from materials. But we still, regardless of what the hell they try to distance themselves from it, evolution goes backwards to the first cell in their minds. And abiogenesis is what creates it, an evolutionary process. And so we go back, we keep following this evolutionary process backwards. We go from the first cell to the materials which created the first cell, which evolved into the first cell from which it evolved. And that would be, according to evolutionists, minerals, which came from rocks. See, evolutionists believe that acidic rain and weathering broke down rock material in the earth into a primordial goo, which somehow assembled itself into this unimaginable complexity, interdependence of beauty we call life. So, if we follow evolution backwards, we get to broken down rocks, we get minerals, which somehow evolved, organized, to create the first cell. So here's my questions to the evolutionists. I don't want an answer, I want you to answer for yourself. Why doesn't the imaginary Darwinian tree of life go far enough backwards, down into the ground, to its roots, to include these? That's a rock. You see, if you're an evolutionist, you believe you're related to these things. Because the ancestors of the first cell was minerals that came from rocks. So, where's your phylogenic tree, which shows the similarity of life to rocks? I mean, where's the taxonomy there? You know, metamorphic rocks, and we've got sedimentary rock, and then there's, you know, there's various kinds of rock. Why are you not producing this phylogenic tree to show that your ancestors were these guys? I mean, you do believe you're related to rocks, right? I mean, we call the first ancestors of, you know, this, that, and we go backward and we have the first cell. And the first cell, therefore, the ancestors of the first cell are minerals. And the minerals themselves, which organized to create the first cell, came from rocks. So you have to believe that all the rocks in the world are related to each other. And because we go back, see, now we keep going further back. We can keep pushing this thing back. Evolution goes back, see, all the way from the first rock to, I mean, you know, this accretion disk idea, this lunacy idea that a gas giant, a planet, a star exploded, left behind our star and the materials which created our solar system, which accreted into a flat accretion disk, which doesn't make sense for lots of reasons. For one thing, the planets aren't in a flat elliptical plane to the sun. And other things, lots of things. That's a whole other subject. But so you have to believe that those molecules are related, and we keep going back to a Big Bang, right? See, so I mean, you have to believe that the Big Bang was the grandpappy of all ancestors. Whatever created the Big Bang, we can go further back. See, so I want to know. I don't really want to know. I want you to ask yourself, why don't you talk about these? How come you don't talk about how you're related to rocks? Is it because it demonstrates that evolutionism is quite stupid and scientifically fallacious? It does, doesn't it? Something you should think about. If you're an evolutionist, you think you're related to this thing distantly. But life doesn't arise from that. The law of biogenesis is scientific fact. But, you know, evolutionists call creationists and Christians nuts. We're lunatics. We're science denialists. Hey, but I'm not the one who says